Okay, so today we're going to be taking a look at negative indices. So when we're dealing with negative indices, we're actually looking for the reciprocal or the inverse. So taking a look at this first example, I've got 3 to the power of negative 1. So when we see that negative power, we know it's going to be a reciprocal. So what we want to write straight away is 1 over. Then once we've done that, we're going to write the number that we were given again, but this time without the negative. So I would have 3 to the power of 1 on the bottom. So we know 3 to the power of 1 is just 3, so this would be equal to 1 over 3, or a third. So that's all we have to do when we see a negative power. We have to do 1 over whatever the number is to the positive power. So we can check this because we know a number multiplied by its reciprocal should always be equal to 1. So originally I have 3, without the negative sign there, that would be 3 to the 1. 3 to the power of 1, which we know is just 3. And we've just figured out the reciprocal of that because we had 3 to the negative 1. So it was 1 over the positive power, so that was 1 over 3. If I multiply these two things together, I get 3 over 3, which is equal to 1. So I know that that is therefore the reciprocal, or the inverse. Okay, for this next question, I've got 3 to the power of negative 2. So for this one, I see that negative sign. So straight away, I'm going to do my 1 over because it's going to be an inverse. And then all I do is I write the number down to the positive power. So this would be 3 squared. Simplifying this, we've still got 1 on the top. Then on the bottom, we've got 3 squared, which is 9. So that would be 1/9. So again, checking it, that 3 to the power of negative 2 means it's the inverse or the reciprocal of 3 squared. Because we know that 3 squared is 9. We've just figured out that 3 to the power of negative 2, or the inverse of 3 to the power of 2, is 1 over 9. Multiplying these together, we get 9 over 9, which is equal to 1. Okay, let's take a look at some more questions. Okay, if you want to have a go at these questions first, feel free to pause the video here and we'll go through them in just a few seconds. Okay, for this first question, we've got 4 to the power of negative 2. So we see that negative power, we know it's going to be a reciprocal. So the first thing we write is 1 over, and then we're going to write 4 to the power of the positive 2 this time. So we've got 1 over 4 squared. So simplifying that, we've got 1 over 4 squared is 16. So 16 on the bottom. So our final answer would be 1 over 16. Okay, for this next question, we've got 5 to the power of negative 3. So again, our negative indices, we know we're going to put 1 over, and then we'd put 5 to the power of, this time, positive 3. So there we have 1 over 5 cubed is 125. So our final answer would be 1 over 125. Okay, for this next question, we've got 3 to the power of negative 2 multiplied by 2 to the power of negative 3. So looking at the first one, we've got 3 to the power of negative 2. So that's the same as saying 1 over 3 to the power of 2. And then we're going to be multiplying that by 2 to the power of negative 3. So we see that negative indices again. So we have 1 over, and then we do it to the positive power. So that would be 2 cubed. So simplifying then, what do we get? Well, we've got 1 over 3 squared, which is 9. And then we're multiplying that by 1 over 2 cubed, which is 8. So multiplying them through, our final answer would be 1 over 72. Okay, for this next question, we've got 3 to the power of negative 3 multiplied by 5 to the power of negative 2. So this first one we can write as 1 over, and then we're going to have 3 to the power of positive 3. Then we're multiplying that by, again, 1 over, because we've got a negative power, but this time we'd have 5 to the power of positive 2, or 5 squared. So simplifying them through, 1 over 3 cubed, well, 3 cubed is 27, so that would be 1 over 27. Then we're multiplying that by 1 over 5 squared, well, 5 squared is 25. So to finish in that, after multiplying them through, we'd have 1 over, then we've got 27 times 25. Well, we know 25 squared is 625. We've got another two lots of 25, so that's another 50. So in total, we'd have 675. So our final answer for that one is 1 over 675. Okay, well done if you had a go at them and got them right. Let's have a look at some more questions. So for this first question, we've got 2/3 to the power of negative 1, which is basically finding the reciprocal of 2/3 to the power of positive 1. So when we're finding the reciprocal of a fraction, all we have to do is flip it upside down and make sure we apply the positive index to it. So 2 over 3 to the power of negative 1 is 3 over 2 to the power of positive 1, which is just 3 over 2. As we discussed with the earlier questions, a number multiplied by its reciprocal will always be 1. So let's check that. We were trying to find the reciprocal of 2/3, and we got an answer of 3 over 2. So multiplied by 3 over 2. Well, if I multiply those fractions through, I have 2 times 3, which is 6, times over 3 times 2, which is also 6. So 6 over 6 is 1. So therefore, I know I found the reciprocal because they multiply to give us 1. Okay, for this next question, I've got 3/4 to the power of negative 2. So again, because we see a negative, we know we've got a reciprocal. And because we've got a fraction, we know all we have to do is flip it and apply the positive index. So 3 over 4 would become 4 over 3 to the power of, we have positive 2 now. So now all we have to do is square our fraction. So we've got 4 squared, which is 16, over 3 squared, which is 9. So again, we can check that because we were looking for the reciprocal of 3/4 all squared, which is 9 over 16. So then 3/4 squared, which was 9 over 16, multiplied by our reciprocal, which was 16 over 9, gives us 144 over 144, which again is equal to 1. Okay, let's have a look at some more questions. Okay, so again, if you want to have a go at these questions first, please feel free to pause the video here and we'll go through them in just a few seconds. Okay, so for this first question, we've got 2/3 to the power of negative 3. So when we see this negative power, we know we've got a reciprocal. And as we know now, when we have a fraction, all we have to do is flip it upside down. So this would be the same as saying 3 over 2, all to the power of, this time, positive 3. So we're going to cube it. So we need to now cube top and bottom. So 3 cubed is 27. And then on the bottom, 2 cubed would be 8. So our final answer for that one would be 27 over 8. Okay, for our next question, we've got 6 over 11 to the power of negative 2. So again, negative power, the reciprocal, we're going to flip the fraction. So this would become 11 over 6. And then we're going to apply the positive power. So we'd have squared. So then all we have to do is square top and bottom. So 11 squared is 121. And then on the bottom, we'd have 6 squared, which is 36. So the final answer for that one would be 121 over 36. Okay, and for our final question today, we've got 2/3 to the power of negative 3 multiplied by 3/4 to the power of negative 2. So again, negative indices, we're finding the reciprocal, so we're going to flip these fractions. So 2 over 3 becomes 3 over 2. And we're going to apply the positive power. So instead of negative 3, we'd have cubed this time, positive 3. And then we're going to multiply that by, again, flipping the 3/4. We now have 4 over 3 to the power of, this time it would be 2, so we're squaring it. So now let's apply these powers to both fractions. So we'd have 3 cubed, which is 27, over 2 cubed, which is 8. And then we're multiplying that by 4 squared, which is 16, over 3 squared, which is 9. Okay, so if we multiply them through, 27 multiplied by 16 is 432. And then on the bottom, we've got 8 times 9, which is 72. The question states to fully simplify, and this one actually works out really nice because if we do 432 divided by 72, it's actually 6. So again, a big well done if you had a go at these and got them right. And that's it for today's video. I hope you found it useful. If you did, please feel free to leave a like and consider subscribing. If there are any specific topics at all that you'd like me to go through next, then please just let me know down in the comments. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.